Hello everyone, welcome to another University of Connecticut UPDC Construction Project Update. My name is Luke. Today is November 3rd, 2016. We're going to be taking you through the progress on our new rec center.
Let's begin with the progress of our utilities where we left off at the tunnel. We cannot see the tunnel any longer because it's buried, but there's the services that come directly out of the tunnel. The left-hand side is the fire service. Then in the middle is the condensate and steam in the chilled water supply and return to the right. Comes up, takes its first bend. The structure that you see on the right-hand side is the chilled water vault. That's where the chilled water is going to be terminated until we get the new building up. We're now traveling over the expansion joint as we head closer to Wetton. And this concrete structure on the corner is actually the stairway. See how close the steam lines come to the corner of Wetton. In this location, they turn and enter into the building. Now we'll take a look from the south to the north now. Again, better view of where the utilities enter into the building. And again, the close proximity to the corner. Now this is the steam and condensate that we're looking at and the expansion loop. So it's good to get an idea where it is in relationship to the sidewalk. You'll always be able to find it again just with that view. The chilled water vault where the terminations are going to be made. You see the bends according to this radius. And that's the progress of the utilities.
We're looking at the new steam lines as they enter into the Wetton building. We were in this location the last video. There's the temporary line. Now you can actually see why we had to run a temporary steam line so we can keep active steam into the building while we install the new pipes. We'll go down and take a look at the joints a little closer in a minute. We actually get an opportunity to take a look at the existing telecommunication duct bank, and there will be the new duct bank that's right over the top of it to the left-hand side. So we'll backfill the steam, we'll bring the soils up, they'll run the new telecommunication duct bank, which we saw in the previous video that ran through the Dodd parking lot, and then the existing telecommunication duct bank will be removed. We'll throw in a little tidbit of information. In order to keep our trench dry during rain events, what you're looking at is a temporary well point. And we call that because the excavation was down a little bit deeper. There's a pipe in the area, it's wrapped in stone. The water's allowed to come in, and there's a pump in the bottom there. You can see the electrical line. And that keeps the water table well down to the well point, which is at the bottom. Keeps our trench high and dry during the installation of the piping services. Following the steam and condensate return, get a closer look at our completed expansion loop. They still have the installation on the jacket to finish up another well point. And this provides expansion and contraction as the line heats up and cools down. As we look more to the School of Business to the north, this week they also installed the chilled water supply and return vault. And that's where the service is going to stop at this particular point. It's going to come out of the tunnel into the vault. And then when the new building is ready, they'll run the lines from the vault to the building. Another well point that you see there. Modern fit-up clamp. Pretty ingenious method right here. So this is, they put the two pipes together, and this is used to fair up the joint to make sure that it's equal. Hey, do me a favor, crank on that on the top so we show what it looks like. Yeah, go ahead. So with a simple turn on the clamp, you can see how it brings that in, brings this surface flush with the other surface, and then the little pins if you want to change from one direction to the next, and really simplifies the process, speeds it up. You're looking at the conduit, the jacket. So we showed you on the previous video the actual carrier pipe, which is on the inside. It's welded up completely. We did the hydrostatic test. This is the steam, this is the condensate line. And remember, the pipes run inside this conduit. So after they were welded, they were wrapped in insulation, and then the sleeve was put on. So we just completed another air test, 15-pound air test, and the joints were soaked. We'll go over that in a minute. The leak detection wire was completed, the connections on the leak seal connectors that they use on that. We test the casing on here, or otherwise known as the conduit. You were just watching the mechanic do what we call a soap test. So there's 15 pounds of pressure on the test end inside of the building. And then we soap each joint. And even if there's the most minor leak, the soap will bubble up and indicate it. Because even 15 pounds of a pinhole leak would not show up for a period of time. But with the soap test, you know, it's a guarantee if there was even the minorest of leak, it would bubble.
Let's move from utilities to our next process, which is our soil remediation. And the short story is the material that was in place around the existing grad dorms was not strong enough to be able to support the new rec center and has to be replaced.
So a great opportunity to take a look at this full operation here. So the idea was to remove the existing material that was a hodgepodge mix. This great location to see the D mark where you see the flags in through here. So the idea is to get down the virgin soil, and this is the location here. Then they're stockpiling the existing material, and to be able to take advantage of when a truck delivers new material, he can take away existing material. So 1 foot lifts is how they place it. You can see the excavator is shaking the material. This is the right this level here, and then you see another level up here and another level up here, and finally we're pretty close to the existing grade right over here. So the truck drops the materials off, the bulldozer also helps to shake it out, and finally we have a vibratory roller that compacts the material, again in 1 foot lifts. The fellow that you see just behind the bulldozer, each lift is tested. We use a nuke tester to test the compaction levels to meet the design criteria, and all of this is so that we have the right bearing capacity for the new building, which will start in the spring. So a great opportunity to explain a little how things changed. Last video we talked about being kind of excited to be able to remove this storm drainage line, one of the last utilities through here, so that we could bring the structural fill closer to the retaining wall that will get removed for the next phase of utilities. And what we found was the material was loose underneath the storm drainage. We were not able to take it out, and just to be on the safe side, we left it. So here's a clear D mark location, and D mark stands for the difference between one area and the next is the line they call the D mark location. So when we do the next phase of utilities out here in Hillside on the sidewalk, the new steam line that comes back in here, we'll remove the retaining wall and we'll tie in the structural fill. Because the new building foundation comes out to somewheres in this location right here. This week we also was a great time to remove the trees. You can see we began to remove the trees in this section and the stone wall over towards here. Next week all of these trees, part of this contract, will be removed. So we were actually, when I was discussing the trees, we were actually standing in the swimming pool. We talk about this sometimes, a unique opportunity to be in a location of a building that will never be back again. So it'll be some time before the pool is built, but this is the area of the building over and through here where the pool will eventually be. We can get an idea of the magnitude of this cut and fill that we were talking about. Some areas it's up to 14 feet. There's an existing storm drainage structure that was at grade at one time. You gotta remember there was building foundations in through here. And some of the deeper utilities, the actual cut was somewhere in the 14 foot range. And that's a great way to look back. We had the earlier video was done up on the top of the hill up in this location here. And the testing lab, you can see with this new tester in front of us doing the compaction tests on each particular lift as they come in. So finally, to describe the material that's coming in a little bit, this is what we call 3.5 inch minus, which means all the stones are 3.5 inches minus, sometimes called structural gravel. So it's a material that was made up at the gravel yard to a specific design, a specific what we call gradation. So many stones fall in the category of 3.5 inch minus, so many 2 inch minus, 1 inch minus, and different sifts. And that is so that the compaction can be monitored. The moisture, it has to be a particular moisture, and the bearing capacity with this material can be determined. Knowing the material, the sieve, and the proctor, they can determine that the material compacted through with a tester is at 95% or greater.
Once again, we want to thank our colleague, Milton Levin, for his amazing drone footage. And that concludes our Rec Center November 4th, 2016 progress update. We thank you for your interest in our university projects. Have a great day.